I already did that feature and got the niggas about
it. Alright, ASAP Twelvyy.
They can't see nothing.
What's going on? Alright, how's it going?
What's good, bro?
Alright, so Chris Green here. I'm just gonna...
My man Chris Green, ASAP Twelvyy, we here.
Alright, ASAP Twelvyy.
What's
good, good. Alright, so what do you know about the festival, first of all? Anything?
If I'm correct, is Quincy Jones in the building?
Yeah, he's in the building.
So, hopefully Quincy Jones check my set out, you know. I heard Michael Jackson did this drink some years back, you know. Jimi Hendrix did this. Happy belated birthday, Quincy Jones, you know what I'm saying? But, very legendary company, man. Yeah. Oh, God.
And now you're one of the legends, so like... ASAP Twelvyy, ASAP Mob. Where's the whole name come from? ASAP Twelvyy.
ASAP Twelvyy. It stems from 212 Mel. You know, 212, 212. That's the area code for New York. One of the, you know, biggest cities in the world. You know what I'm saying? Well, one of the most active cities in the world. Fly. You know what I'm saying? Because I've been in Europe lately, and they can compete. You know what I'm saying? Paris, Montreux. I'm gonna go UK soon, so I know they could compete. You know, Berlin, you know what I'm saying? So it's a dope city, you know what I'm saying? And I took the code, you know, the suffix, the prefix, you know what I'm saying? And I just, 12, it's like, ASAP 212 was kind of, like, I might start going by ASAP 212, but ASAP 12, you just flowed together. And 12 is the name of SpongeBob Jellyfish, and jellyfishes are the key to immortality. So, you know what I'm saying? I'm here, long live ASAP.
And the whole idea of ASAP, like always strive and prosper. Mm-hmm. How did that whole crew come about? How did you put together?
So ASAP Yams and Big Haiti started ASAP. Mm-hmm. You know, they assembled different members, myself, ASAP Ills, ASAP Barbie, Lily, June, Juice, KD, Wes. Jay West, Nas, Fur, Rocky, Ty Beats, Tawa, Relly, Addy, you know what I'm saying? I'm just, you know, I hope I ain't forget nobody. I said Relly and Tawa. Today's Relly's birthday. Happy birthday, Relly. Free Ty Beats. Long live ASAP Yams. You know, Yams in Haiti, they started to jump in back in the days. This is Skonex era. This is before social media took us to where we at now. Like, in the matrix, you know, because I feel like everybody's kind of caught up in the matrix now. It's like you need validation online to be an artist, and I think that's kind of sad, you know, because I feel like something like this,
yeah,
like no social media involved, this is incredible.
Like, you know, just again,
yeah, it's just a conversation, and this is what legends are made of, you know what I'm saying? Because Quincy Jones and Hendrix or Michael Jackson, when they first did it, it was like cameras and stuff, but it wasn't like fans just like looking through their phone at the show. It's like you were really experiencing the show and the energy.
So if someone does that tonight, are you gonna be like no cameras, or you just go with the flow and just?
I'm gonna just let them do what they do, because I know it's a new generation. I know it's a new thing, you know. Because when I came here for the first time with Rocky, I know people had their phones out, but they weren't like, you know, it was live. Yeah. It's live and stuff now. So it's like you go to a show and somebody got their phone in their hand, their whole show, and it's just kind of like, if you like break your phone, and then you gonna lose that.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? Yeah. You know, so it's kind of crazy.
And now you've got like obviously your album.
12.
Yes. 3 years in the making.
My whole life in the making.
Just
but
a musical process.
But the 3 years of actually recording and learning how to record and be a recording artist or a touring artist, performing artist, you know, I think ASAP Rocky to death for that, because I learned so much from him, being with him every day. And you know, just to say, you know, 3 years ago, like, I was probably on a different type of high, and I wasn't really understanding that I could also do this myself, you know what I'm saying? I was pushing my brothers and trying to help my team, my collective, and you know, it's a lot trying to be there for everybody else, you know? Because just to be honest, not everybody going to be there for you.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
That must be difficult with the collective as well. There must be different kinds of...
You know? Like, I will give my all for everybody, but then sometimes when it comes to me, it's just like, I got to kind of, got to do it on my own. Right. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, I'm a man about it though, you know? But that's what I learned from my brothers. It's just like, yeah, you just got to hold it down. And it's all for the team at the end of the day.
Okay. So that's probably why the process maybe was a little bit more labored. You know what I'm saying? Right.
It was even like sometimes being discouraging, not having somebody every day pushing you like, yo, do this, you know? When you probably was pushing everybody every day. Yeah. It's just like, you know, and I also had a hernia. You know, I had a hernia, so I had to get hernia surgery this year. So this is my first time really getting back on the road, getting back into the swing of things.
Limbering up to get hype and to get the crowd going.
Because to be honest, it's like a hernia, inguinal hernia surgery is...
Sounds nasty.
It's hell, you know? And, you know, I like for 2 months of this year, I barely could do anything.
So moving back on to 12, the production on it is great.
Yeah,
we got, you know, Harry.
Harry Fraud. We got
some clams.
Nah, we don't got no clams. You know, clams don't be fucking with Twelvyy like that. You know what I'm saying? But we got P on the boards. We got Hector Delgado. Mm-hmm. We got my man Gordon. We got my man Il Wayno. You know, periodic table. Yeah. Harry Fraud. Who else? Richie. You know, or my man Ricky. My fault. I said Richie because that's how you say it when he in France. So Ricky, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Ricky. Who else?
And now these people obviously they're a huge range of great producers. Mm-hmm. But for me, like, what would be your
Molly Roche? Shout out to Molly Roche.
Okay, what would be your dream producer? Like, say, go back from hip hop to even now. Who would you maybe like to pick? Like, what, Neptunes? I don't know. Like, who would be those?
I like the Neptunes and stuff, but I don't think anybody had production like Mobb Deep. Yeah. Like that. They sonically, it was just something different. Like they sound together, it was just like you know heard Mobb Beat,
Shook
like,
Ones,
you know what I'm saying? All that shit. Like still, you hear this to this day. You like, you know what I'm saying? You know, like Nas and Jay-Z, they got bangers and stuff.
Yeah.
But it's like the Mobb Deep beats. Mm-hmm. It's just like I still got Mobb Infamy. You know all that. You know what I'm saying? Like,
and listening to the way you rap. You have kind of East Coast kind of rhythm or cadence. Mm-hmm. Do you think you're gonna incorporate any other like rap styles within your new work or upcoming work?
I want to be more worldly. You know, I don't want to get stuck in a New York rapper box or you know. But I'm happy that I could showcase one side and then try to showcase something else. You know, I'm trying to learn how to expand my artistry. You know what I'm saying? And you know, I'm growing up, like I'm 29 years old. You know, I don't make super, super turned up music, but I want to make a couple turned up songs. But I want to make songs for the women. I want to make songs for the world, for war, for peace, for fashion, for everything. I want to make songs for NBA games, NFL games. I want to learn how to just be that type of artist that you could just come and be like, yo, I got this for you.
So there's definitely a chance for some sort of collaboration.
Yeah.
And you feel like, what do you know about UK hip hop? Do you know anything about Grime or anything like that? Or like Skepta?
Skepta is one of my favorite artists right now. Cool. You know, Skepta, ASAP Rocky, Praise the Lord. That's a summer banger right there, you know what I'm saying? Giggs.
Giggs is tough.
Section Boys.
Exactly.
So
you think maybe like there might be some sort of like American and US or. US and England, UK connection, maybe you perhaps see what happens. Or?
Look, if I'm willing, like I'm down to work with anybody. You know, I haven't been able to meet too many artists lately because like I said I've been home trying to get better. So it's hard reaching out and it's hard for people to try to understand where you coming from, or they might hear your stuff and be like, how do I make music with him? Or you know, how do I make music like them? So you know, I'm still learning, but as soon as the opportunity presents itself, let's get in the studio, let's do this.
And like in terms of getting in studio and what's the process like, for example, from standouts for me in the album or Diamonds, mm-hmm. Pop Out, mm-hmm. Strap,
mm-hmm.
Do you sit down with the idea and then how does it come about? Like,
Hop Out actually, like even I was in the studio with everybody and they threw the beat on and I freestyled the verse and the hook, and then I think somebody said if I throw a hook, verb on the hook, it'll make it da da da, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I did. That was just in the moment. Like we was all in the studio, verb wasn't on my tape, it was a high energy record, we did it. Diamonds, rest in peace ASAP Yams, it was me, ASAP Yams and Rocky, and we was just all vibing and that's how we got that record. and Strapped. Also, I was in the studio with ASAP Rocky and ASAP Yams, and we were just all vibing and clicking, and that's how that record came out. You know what I'm saying? I'm learning how to make music on my own now. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But it's honestly nothing like being like, I will never be able to make music with Yams again. So it's kind of like, whatever. It's that hurts a lot. You know what I'm saying? But like, it won't change my mentality. It's like I gotta make some fire that I know my brother probably looking at me like, yeah, that shit is hot.
Yeah, you gotta strive.
Yeah, you know. But it's like nowadays, it's like, what is a hit? What is a hot song? Yeah. It's like anything that a label put a certain budget to is, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And then they be putting budgets behind bullshit. You know what I'm saying?
They push and push.
They push bullshit, and then it hurts actual artists like me that really study this and really love this and care about it. But you know what I'm saying, I'm keeping my head in the game, and I'm knowing that, you know, no good deed goes unpunished, and all the work you put in, you get a super positive outcome. And it's like the message I push, I don't tell you to do drugs, I don't tell you to do no suicidal shit, I don't tell you to beat your girl, I don't tell you to, I barely say fuck bitches, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? My name Twelvyy, you know what I'm saying? ASAP Twelvyy, I'm just trying to communicate awareness to you, you know what I'm saying? Because I live this life. Most of this stuff that these people rapped about, I really done did. And then when they was rapping about, I never seen them. You feel me? Like, I was born in Harlem. I seen Bill Clinton in New York, Chris Rock, you know what I'm saying?
Like, you feel you're authentic.
I'm really, this is me, you know, and I just feel like the internet world, they don't respect me because I'm me, you know what I'm saying? They be hating because it's like, you ain't never going to get nobody this authentic, man. Ain't nobody going to be as authentic as ASAP, you feel me?
Yeah.
Organic and natural, and we just try to keep it real.
Cool. All right, so I'm going to ask you one last thing. Mm-hmm. Your trainers, mm-hmm. Someone told me that you're obsessed with trainers.
Yeah.
That you wanted to have your own trainer line.
Yeah.
From Nike, I think.
Well, Nike.
Depends now.
Yeah, it depends. You know, shout out to Nike. I did a lot for Nike. You know what I'm saying? And I feel like they was treating me like a high school basketball player. Let me just give him whatever. You know what I'm saying? If I asked for something real fly, they wasn't sending it to me. So it's like, we make Nike fly, like come on, nobody in Nike wearing these right now. It's way up, you know what I'm saying? So, but shout out to Under Armour. I'm on my Under Armour
flow
right now, you know what I'm saying? But I'm really on my last year being broke flow, and I'm gonna have last year being broke shoes. So, you know what I'm saying? So look, man, I'm direct to consumer. All y'all big businesses, y'all better be aware, because I'm coming. Me and my team coming, and we want in, cause I see y'all not trying to let us in, so we want in. What's up?
Exactly. All right. Thanks very much, man.
All day.
Appreciate it.
Amen. All day.